وكانوا بيتكلموا يعني ما هو أعظم ما في اللغة في القرآن؟ قال الإعجاز النظمي، يعني the order and the usage of certain words. I mean the Quran use some words, but when you use it is ajaz, the nazm and the order of the words. And subhanAllah, today we just reflect on the ayat that the brother Henry recited. يعني تبدأ الآيات يا المزمل قم الليل إلا قليلا نصفه ونقص منه and so on. So start with a command from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Allah سبحانه وتعالى ordered the Prophet to make qiyam. Okay. But in the at the end of the surah, and then إن ربك يعلم أنك تقوم أدنى من ثلثي الليل ونصفه وثلثه. فهي use the word ربك. بعدين والله يقدر الليل والنهار. So let's what if I say إن الله يعلم أنك تقوم أدنى من ثلثي الليل ونصفه وثلثه وربك يقدر الليل والنهار. Make difference? For us it's okay. If you put Allah, replace Allah with Rabbuk or Rabbuk with Allah, does it make difference? And this is what I want everyone to think about it now. Does it make difference or not? And you, what you think? And this is what really took the Arab completely and submitted to Rasulullah. This is a miracle. Because the word Allah and Rabb is for us is very close. There's no difference. يعني مثلا زرت الضحى والضحى إذا زاد جماعة ما ودعك ربك وما قلاك ولا وما قلا. Why did he say ما ودعك وما قلاك؟ ها ودعك يعني left you. He said goodbye. This is وداع. This is goodbye. Farewell. But قلاك hate you. So he لم يستخدم الضمير. يعني ودعك حط الضمير. لكن في قلا ما وضع الضمير. قال وما قلاك. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى didn't use the pronoun for you. Like Allah will say goodbye to you, but when Allah didn't hate, he didn't put you. Allah didn't hate. Why? Because Allah said Allah سبحانه وتعالى loved Rasulullah so much. فلم يضع الضمير لو العاد على رسول الله في قلاك. لما إنه كان ممكن لو يستخدمها كان ممكن تعدي علينا. فهنا سبحان الله كلمة الفرق بين الرب والإله إيه؟ والله الله لما تأتي في العظمة والقدرة الله mighty Allah سبحانه وتعالى the power you know okay but when the word رب comes كلمة الرب تفيد العناية والرعاية والخلق. So the word رب is the one who's created you, the one who's taking care of you. And all the time because رب in Arabic is very close to up. What's your father? Well, مثل الأعلى. يعني Allah has the highest example. The word أب, father, what that your father is doing for you? He's taking care of you and so on, help you, provide you. Well, مثل الأعلى, Allah has the highest example. Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the word رب, when you hear the word رب, it will give you the same feeling. And this is why, in the beginning, اقرأ بسم الله الذي خلق, سورة العلق. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. Because this is the first communication between Allah and Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he used the word رب, the one who created, this one, الذي خلق, the one who created you, the one who is going to take care of you. So it feels لطف, يعني في it's make it easy to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. But the word Allah, I have to worship him. There's a lot of commands, there is a lot of orders I have to follow. But the word رب, there is what? There is more love, there is more ease, there is more taking care of. Okay, so subhanAllah, Allah in Allah command him in the beginning to make qiyam. Inna rabbaka ya'lamu annaka ay taqum. Rabbuka, the one who's taking care of you, the one who wake you up. Because sometimes we feel that we came to the masjid and we pray at night because of our power. No. We came, why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved us so much that he gave us this ni'mah. Ni'mah al-qudum lil-masjid. The ni'mah, the bounty, to come to the masjid. The ni'mah to wake you up because you are sleeping. And al-maut, al-naum what? Maut? Azhar. Yani death is a minor death. And al-mautu naumun akbar. And death is the great sleeping. Okay, so when we are asleep, we're actually dead. Who will wake you up to come even for fajr? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not you. Don't think that you came because of you. يعني mashallah, you set the alarm and the malaika will wake you up. No, you came because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wake you up. Ar-Rabb, the world erupt. So subhanAllah, every time you see the world erupt, you have this feeling of, hey, the one who's taking care of you, the one will help you, the one will provide you, the one will support you, and so on. And then wallahu yuqadiru al-layla wal-nahar. Now we go back to power. Who control day and night? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? And this is how we, the more we understand all these small tips, we will improve our communication with it, with the Quran, and to understand the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more and more. Jazakumullah khair. Qulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh.